Kate's in the kitchen, and you're invited too. Happy fall, everybody. It's the first day of autumn. And in autumn, you start to move towards those comforting, old-fashioned, just hearty dishes. So I'm going to make a meatloaf, but I'm going to tweak it a little. Usually I make either an Italian-flavored meatloaf or Mexican-flavored meatloaf. And with the Italian-flavored meatloaf, one of the things I'd put in is wine. But today, I'm thinking Oktoberfest, and I'm going to go with German style, so it's going to have more of the German flavors in it. So let's get started. I've got two slices of rye bread. It was rather thick slices, so I only needed two, but if it's regular, maybe three. First thing I'm going to do is soak that in about a half a cup of milk. I'm just going to mix that up, and we're going to set that aside and let it get all mushy to where we can actually just mush it up and it'll spread throughout the meatloaf. So I'm gonna set that aside. If your dry bread, if your rye bread is a little dry, you may need a little more milk. When you soak a starch like slices of bread or even breadcrumbs in a liquid, that's called a panade. So this has been sitting for about 10 minutes and it's nice and gloppy. This is the secret to a moist and tender meatloaf. So, in my bowl, I've got a pound of ground pork, because the Germans love their pork, and a pound of ground beef. So you're gonna get the fat from the beef, and you're gonna get flavor from both, but like a different kind of flavor, and this is gonna be delicious. The first thing I'm going to do is mix the panade in with the meats, so that it gets thoroughly combined. Not only the panade, but the two different kinds of meat are completely blended throughout. And then we will set this aside and move on. So I'm gonna go ahead and stir this up. I've got the meats and the panade all mixed up. I'm going to set that aside. Be gentle when you're mixing that. You don't wanna overmix it. You're gonna end up with a tough meatloaf. All right, I'm gonna start with two eggs. Now, when I watch people on TV making meatloaf, they put the meat into the bowl, and then they dump in the eggs and the bread or the panade or whatever, mix it up, then in all the seasonings on top. I don't think you get even distribution that way, so I'm going to do this a little different. I'm going to mix up my eggs. Now, some of the flavors common to German cooking. Juniper. Kind of hard to find juniper berries, but gin works. I've got 2 tablespoons of just regular gin. Got a teaspoon of chopped fresh thyme. About 2 tablespoons of fresh chives. Got about a teaspoon of ground caraway. Now you might wanna start with just half of that. Something like this, I'm actually gonna give it a smell before I pour it into the meat. 1/2 teaspoon of fresh ground black pepper, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire, and about 1/4 cup of fresh minced parsley. So I only put in 1/2 that caraway. I'm gonna give this a smell. Can't smell the caraway at all. I'm gonna put the rest of it in. And sometimes it also depends on how old your spices are. I gotta admit, I don't use caraway a lot, so my caraway might be a little less flavorful. I'm gonna mix in this egg mixture. And again, be gentle. It looks like quite a bit of liquid, but it's going to absorb even further into the bread. This is my secret for getting the seasoning evenly distributed throughout my meatloaf. So we've got 2 secrets here. The panade will keep it moist and tender, and the egg mixture will evenly distribute all your seasonings Okay, that looks pretty good. I don't want to overmix this. I've got my largest loaf pan. I'm going to pour this in. It's pretty full. And then I'm going to press it into the pan and try and get it into the corners so that you can have a nice loaf, an actual meat loaf at the end. I've got my oven preheating, 350 degrees. I'm going to cover this with foil, bake it for about 40, 45 minutes with the foil on. And then I'm going to take the foil off. That's the point when people usually put their cheese on or their ketchup. And one other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a sheet pan on the bottom rack of my oven in case this decides to boil over, because I don't want a big stinky mess. So into the oven we go. While the meatloaf is cooking, I'm going to make a glaze to put on at the end. I'm going to start with some ketchup. Now, ketchup is American, but it was invented by a German immigrant. So I've got about maybe 3 tablespoons of that. Mustard is very popular in Germany, so I'm going to use like a heaping teaspoon of some whole grain mustard. You could use some German mustard. You could use spicy brown mustard, honey mustard, whatever you like. I'm going to give it a little bit of honey to cut that vinegar in the ketchup and also to make it more sticky as a glaze. I'm going to give that a mix. You could put a little hot sauce in here if you want to spice it up. And then I'm going to give it a little bit of dill. And once the meatloaf's cooked about 40, 45 minutes, I'm going to take the foil off and paint this across the top in a thin layer. It smells delicious. Here's a little tip. I took my meatloaf out after about 45 minutes. It's just about done. It's at 150 degrees. And if you notice that there's a bit of oil, maybe the ground beef you've got is fatty or the sausage, you can just tip your pan and get a paper towel in there and it'll soak up the oil. So you can just hold that to one corner, all the oil will come down and you won't have a big puddle of oil at the bottom of your pan. I actually don't seem to have too much oil in there today. I'm going to put my glaze on top and I'm going to spread it out with a pastry brush. I don't want a big, thick, gloppy layer. I just want it to be thin, like a glaze. And then I'm going to put this back in the oven for about 5 minutes or so till this gets a little stickier. And you want the meatloaf to be about 160 degrees finished temperature. And I'm almost there. Like I said, I was at about 150. All right, back into the oven without the foil. We have our finished meatloaf and the glaze has gotten nice and sticky and shiny. I'm going to slice it up and time to eat. Here we have the finished product. The meatloaf is so tender, and that's what I'm going to taste first. Definitely not an Italian flavor. You just get hints of even the gin, the juniper, the thyme, and then that mustard and ketchup glaze on there. I just got that caraway. And we'll give the cabbage a taste. It's one of our favorites. They go perfect together because this is, I don't want to say hot, but a little spicy, like aromatic spicy. And this is a little less so, and it cuts that. They complement each other great. And then I've got a slice of that caraway rye bread. My grandma, we always had bread, buttered bread when she cooked. I hope you have a great Oktoberfest. I hope you give this a try. Auf Wiedersehen.